morning everyone. So from today onwards, we are going to start our second semester classes. So first semester, we have learned about all the basics about the statistics, the descriptive statistics, the mathematical expectation and the random variables, different types of random variables. So all that is a basic you have to remember for all your 3 years. So don't forget about the basics. Keep practicing and keep reading all those basics, because without that basics you cannot continue to the further classes. You have to be thorough with each and every terminology of the statistics. So today we are going to start our second semester classes. So coming to second semester, in first semester our paper name or the paper title was Descriptive Statistics and Probability. So coming to the second semester, our paper title is Probability Distributions. So in the first sem, we have learned only about the descriptive statistics and the probability. So it means how your population is described, or how your data is described, just to know about the central tendency or dispersion, the variation in the data, or the central part of the observations. All this we have studied, and also some averages like movements, mathematical expectations and the probability. So now probability distributions. So we have studied a little about the probability distributions in our last session. That is in our third unit, first semester. What is our third unit? Random variables. What is a random variable? Random variable, it is a real value function defined on the each and every outcome of the sample space of the random experiment. So for random experiment, you will have a sample space that is set of all possible outcomes. So the described only, a function described on the each and every outcome of that sample space is called as the random variable. And we have two types of random variables, right? One is discrete random variable and the other is continuous random variable. So what is a discrete random variable? If you have the countable number of values, so the finite number of values, that is considered as the discrete random variable. Coming to continuous random variable, if the value of the random variable is within the limits, within the specified limits, that means your x is between 2 to 3, 4 to 5. That is called as the continuous random variable. So we have studied about these two random variables before. But and we have also studied the concepts of PMF and PDF, that is probability mass function and probability density function. What is a probability mass function? The probability function assigned to the discrete random variable is called probability mass function, that is PMF, and the probability function assigned to the continuous random variable is called the probability density function, that is PDF. Now coming to the probability distribution, so if every random variable, you will be having random variable, right? Suppose if every random variable is assigned with a particular loss of probability, that is coming to probability distribution. If a random variable, if you have any random variable, if that random variable is distributed according to some loss of probability, then that distribution is called as the probability distribution. A random variable, you will be having a random variable, and for that random variable, you will be having different values for the random variable. So if that random variable values are distributed according to some loss of the probability. So probability means a probability distribution. So based on the type of the random variable, we are going to have two types of probability distributions that you already know. What are the two types of probability distributions? First one is discrete probability distribution and second one is continuous probability distributions. If the random variable is discrete, it is called a discrete distribution. If the random variable is continuous, it is called as a continuous probability distribution. Now, I'll give you the syllabus for your second semester. So first page, you write down the syllabus. After writing the syllabus, then coming to unit 1, you write the introduction part. That is whatever I've written about the probability distribution. That introduction part you write in your unit 1 introduction. So before that, note down the syllabus. So coming to syllabus, in the second sem, same like the first sem, we are having total 4 units. So 4 units are divided like this means, first 2 units you will be having the discrete distributions and the next 2 units you will be having the continuous distribution. So first write down the unit 1. So coming to unit 1 syllabus, so the unit 1 is discrete distributions 1. So in the first unit we are going to learn about the few of the discrete distributions. Those are, the first one is uniform distribution. The first distribution among the discrete distribution is uniform distribution. And next one is Bernoulli distribution. Uniform distribution and Bernoulli distribution. So for these two distributions, we are going to learn the definitions. Definitions. And we are going to derive the mean and variance for these two distributions and also some examples on the real life applications of these two distributions. So first part is, we are going to learn the uniform distribution, Bernoulli distribution. These are very small distributions, so that's why we'll be considering only, we'll be learning only definition, mean, variance and some examples. Next is, we are going to study about the definition and derivation of the PMF of binomial distribution. So after uniform Bernoulli, next is we are going to study about the binomial distribution. So coming to this binomial distribution, first we will learn the definition and the derivation of the PMF. So this distribution will have some PMF. So we will derive how do we call that PMF, that is comes under the derivation of the PMF. Next, Poisson distribution. Along with the definition and derivation and PMF of the binomial distribution and Poisson distribution, so for these two distributions, that is for the binomial distribution and the Poisson distribution, we are going to learn the definition and the derivation of the PMF and the properties of these distributions. Properties of these distributions. So the different properties for these distributions, like deriving the MGF, CGF, PGF and characteristic function CF. So all those properties and deriving the moments, mean, variance, all those properties we will be deriving for the both binomial and Poisson distributions. So properties such as median, period and movements up to the fourth order. And movements up to fourth order. So what does movement up to fourth order means? The first four movements we are going to derive, that is mu1, mu2, mu3 and mu4. Central movements, to find the central movements, first we will find the non-central movements, right? So the movements up to the fourth order. Next property is reproductive properties. So these reproductive property means it is the additive property. So for MGF, CGF, all this in our last and fourth unit, we had some properties called as additive property. So that additive property is called as the reproductive property. So for the binomial distribution and Poisson distribution, we are going to derive the reproductive property. So wherever it is existed. And then real life applications. And next is real life applications. Next is last topic in this unit is Poisson approximation to binomial distribution. Poisson approximation to binomial distribution. Poisson approximation to binomial means under certain conditions Poisson distribution will tend to the binomial distribution. So that we will be deriving. So this complete paper itself, that is probability distributions, is a derivative part. You will be deriving all the probability functions and the different properties for those distributions. So coming to the unit 1. Unit 1 is discrete distribution 1. So in this unit 1, you will learn uniform distribution and binomial distribution. For these two distributions, only definition, mean, variance and examples. Coming to the binomial and Poisson distributions, along with the derivation of the PMF, we will derive the movements, we will derive all the properties such as median, mode, MGF, CGF, CF, PGF and all the movements up to the fourth order, the reproductive property and the real life applications of these two distributions. Next last topic is Poisson approximation to binomial distribution. So this is the unit 1. Copy the syllabus. Next we will study about the unit 2. So coming to unit 2, unit 2 also is related to the discrete distributions. So discrete distributions 2, that is the second part of the discrete distributions. So in the first part we have only 4 distributions, uniform, Bernoulli, binomial and Poisson. So in the second part we will be learning about the negative binomial. And the geometric distribution. Negative binomial and geometric distribution. So these two are also the discrete distributions. Negative, we are going to learn in the second unit, that is negative binomial and geometric distributions. So for this also we are going to derive all the properties like mean, median, mode, wherever it exists. So all these comes under the, we can write as the properties of these distributions. Properties of these two distributions, such as in brackets you can write down MGF, CGF, MGF, CGF, CF, PGF and movements up to fourth order. Movements up to fourth order. So these few distributions, negative binomial and geometric, and their properties and also their reproductive lack of memory property for the geometric distribution. So for geometric distribution, we are going to have an extra property called as the lack of memory property, which is very important. Next, Poisson approximation to negative binomial. Poisson approximation to negative binomial. So under some conditions, this Poisson distribution will tend to be negative binomial distribution. So we will see that derivation. Next, second part of the unit 2 is we are going to learn about the hypergeometric distribution. So this is the first part, this is the second part. We are going to learn about the hypergeometric distribution. Very important distribution in the second unit, that is hypergeometric distribution. So coming to this hypergeometric distributions, we will learn only the definition. We will learn only the definition, and they are the mean and variance. So this will be a little bit lengthy one. That's why only for the hypergeometric distribution we will be deriving mean and variance only. Next, binomial approximation to hypergeometric. Binomial approximation. So same here also, binomial distribution will tends to be hypergeometric distribution under some conditions. So we will derive that relationship between the binomial and the hypergeometric distribution. So up to this unit 2, we are going to have all the discrete distributions. In the first unit, we will learn uniform, Bernoulli, binomial, Poisson. Here we will learn negative binomial. Sixth one is geometric. Seventh one is hypergeometric. So all these seven distributions we are going to learn under the discrete distributions. Now we will see the unit 3. So unit 3 is about the continuous distributions.
And properties.
binomial and poisson. So we are going to study about the limiting case. So in the previous units also we have written the distribution, some distribution tends to other distributions. Like that only this binomial and poisson distribution tends to the normal distribution under some conditions. So this is about the unit 3. Next is unit 4. So unit 4, the continuous distributions itself, the second part of the continuous distributions. So in this is unit 4, we are going to learn about the first is exponential distribution.
Write down the syllabus in the first page. In the next class, we'll start our unit 1.